15, verse 32, down to verse 36, and including 36. While the people of Israel were in the wilderness, they surprised a man gathering wood on the Sabbath day. Those who had surprised him gathering the wood brought him to Moses, Aaron, and the whole congregation. But they were obliged to put him in confinement because there was no distinct ruling on how he should be punished. The man must most certainly be executed, the Lord told Moses. Have the entire congregation hurl stones at him outside the camp. So the whole congregation took him outside the camp and threw stones at him until he died, as the Lord had directed Moses. Okay, Joshua 2, from verse 1 down to verse 24. Okay, then Joshua the son of Nun sent two men from Acacia secretly to spy. Go, he said, survey the land and Jericho in particular. So they went, and coming to the house of the harlot whose name was Rahab, they stayed there. But it was reported to the king of Jericho, men have come here this night from the Israelites to spy out the land. Then the king of Jericho sent word to Rahab, bring out the men who came to you into your house, because they have come to spy out the whole land. Now the woman had taken the two men to hide them. Yes, the men did come to me, she replied, but I did not know where they came from. However, at dusk, when the gate was to be closed, they went away. I do not know where the men went. Pursue them quickly, so you may catch up with them. She had taken them up to the roof and had hidden them in the flax stalks, which she had laid out there. Meanwhile, the men pursued them along the Jordan road as far as the fords, and they closed the gate as soon as the pursuers went out after them. Before they fell asleep, she went up to them on the roof and said to them, I know that the Lord has given you this country, that the fear of you has come upon us, and that all the inhabitants of the land melt with terror because of you. For we have heard how the Lord dried up the water of the Red Sea when you came out of Egypt, and also what you did to the two kings of the Amorites in the other side of Jordan, to Sihon and Og, whom you destroyed. We heard it, and our courage melted away. No one is confident against you any longer, because the Lord your God is God in the heavens above and on earth beneath. So now, please swear to me by the Lord that as I have treated you kindly, you too will show kindness to my father's house. Besides, give me a pledge of your good faith that you will spare my father and mother, my brothers and sisters, and all that belong to them, and save us from death. Then the men said to her, if you do not expose our mission, we shall treat you kindly and faithfully when the Lord gives the land to us, or may we die in your place. She let them down then through the window with a rope, for her house was on the side of the wall, so that she actually lived on the wall. She said to them, go into the mountains, or your pursuers will apprehend you. Remain there for 3 days until your pursuers return, then you may go your way. The men said to her, we may be released from this oath that you made us swear, unless when we come into the land, you tie this piece of scarlet cord in the window by which you let us down and assemble your mother, father, brothers, and all your relatives at your house. Should anyone go out through the doors of your house into the street, his blood will be on his own head, and we are innocent. But with regard to anyone who is with you in the house, his blood is on our head if a hand is raised against him. But if you expose this mission of ours, we shall be released from the oath which you made us swear. Let it be according to your terms, she replied. After she dismissed them, they left, and she fastened the scarlet cord in the window. They went out and came to the mountains, where they stayed for 3 days until their pursuers returned. Their pursuers had hunted them all along the road, but they did not discover them, so the two men started back. They came down from the mountains, and after they crossed over, they came to Joshua, son of Nun, and reported all their findings to him. They announced to Joshua, the Lord has put the whole land in our hands, and all its inhabitants are faint-hearted before us. Baruch Hashem.
Thank you.